Hey guys, this is Nefarious411 and welcome to episode 8 of Regrowth. So in between episodes, I haven't really done too much. I have tried to collect the essence as much as possible, but for some reason this line right here doesn't want to grow anymore. I don't really know why. It just stopped. It's just been sitting there. The copper, as you can see, it's been going on and on, but I don't know what's going on with the iron here. I was hoping that the iron would actually grow a little bit faster, because right now it's only at 343, so that is really unfortunate. So I'm just going to keep this one going. I'm hoping that it'll go a little bit faster, a little bit further, because I would like to get it all the way to the very end. It looks like the coal is almost done. If I come over here to analyze, hopefully we're near 10, 10, 10. Well, 9, 8, 10. That is not bad at all. Of course, we'll have to probably run it back maybe to a quarter of the way, I don't know. But in today's episode, I want to do a little bit of building, because I want to go ahead and finish up here. I'm not sure if I'm going to complete this up here. I'm struggling with ideas, because I'm wanting this to kind of look like an abandoned, like, I don't know, riverfront, grain mill or something like that. A little farmhouse, so I'm not exactly sure how to get that look. The first thing that I'm gonna do is come in here and replace these, because I think these limestone bricks will probably look a little bit better in terms of abandonment. because these look a little bit more on the weathered side than these cobblestone, because I think the large portion of the building I'm gonna do in limestone. So let me go ahead and do this, because what I'm building right here is essentially going to be a water tower slash silo. I thought that would be a pretty good touch. So let me go ahead and build up the sides, and you can kind of see what I'm going for, the other look. I'm trying to hug this a little bit close, otherwise the radius on this silo would probably be a little bit too large. I tried going out to like a 9x9, and that just didn't look very good, so I'm sticking with this, and this is a 7x7. So let me go ahead and make a door so that I can get in, because there is going to be a little maintenance area. So if I were to build up the sides, oops, did not mean to do that one. There we go. So this will give us a general sense of what this is going to look like. And I think this is going to turn out pretty well. I mean, I don't have anything like a builder's wand or anything like that in this pack, so I'm going to end up having to do all of this by hand. I don't think the builder's wand is in here. Nah, I didn't think so. I think that's extra utilities. So that's a little unfortunate. I could wait until I have a little bit more tech, but I kind of like the building aspect. I mean, this is going down to the roots of Minecraft, before robots and everything else existed. So this is kind of a good way to do it. Alright, so I am just going to build it up just a little bit, not too high, because I'm not going to bore you with all of the building aspect of it. I just want to get a good sense of what this will look like. There we go. Nice. So I don't know how tall this is going to be. This is actually going to turn out really well. One of the things that I did notice, you can see that my water channel is kind of low on water. This cannot handle the condensation required to do two pumps or two sprinklers. So I might have to do something in regards to fixing that. And one of the things that I thought about doing is basically just creating another one. I mean, they are cheap. They're not that expensive at all. I think it's just the matter of iron that it's going to take. So let me go ahead and grab the iron that I have. I have 8. So what was that? Wall. What were those called? Reservoir? No. I'm just going to look in my quest book since it was just right here. If I can remember which line this was. I can never remember. Here we go. This is a water tank siding. I was completely wrong. Alright, so that one is a little bit of iron and a pipe sealant. And I do not know where my pipe sealant went. So while I'm looking for that, I am going to go ahead and create a couple more stacks, or 16 iron. Let that go while I come upstairs. Probably should sleep through the night first. Bah! Come on, come on, come on. I'm in a rush. I'm excited for this build. It's been a while since I've done any of the larger builds, so this is going to be fun. There we go. So let me grab that. And I guess that was it. Oh, where's my pipe sealant? What did I do with that? Ah, there it is. My green bag. That makes sense. Green pipe sealant. And I still don't know. Looks like I need some of these planks. There we go. And just create a handful. There we go. Run back over here. And I should be able to start setting this up. But what I want to do is probably use these carpenter's barriers in between. And the reason I'm doing this is because I would like these to kind of be set apart. I don't think the water tank can actually sit on each other without destroying the other one. So let me just see. Yeah, I can't even access the inventory. So that is not going to be something that we can do. So they need to be at least one block apart. And that's why I'm going to use these carpenter's barriers. There we go. Cool. And now let's just finish up this tank. And I might do a third depending on how tall this is. There we go. Yay. Yeah, I might end up doing a third. Let's just see how well this works, because the next part of what I want to work on is probably in chapter 5. Yes. So pipe dream. And this is going to start some of our automation stuff. And it looks like we need to create wooden transport pipes and cobblestone transport pipes. And that's going to require a little bit of glass. So let me see if I have any sand running around here. And I do. Don't think I need any of that. Yeah, I got wood on me. Don't have to worry about that. And that. Wow, that was good timing. So let me go ahead and throw some this in the furnace, and this will create some glass. And the glass is going to be used to create these pipes. So let me go ahead and grab one for now. And this could be for my wooden pipe. There we go. That creates 8 for us. And that should have completed that one. So now the next one is cobblestone. And I think I might have to convert some of this back into cobblestone. Let me grab my chisel. There we go. Put the glass in the middle and the cobblestone on both sides, and we have cobblestone transport pipe. There we go. So the wooden engine is a little bit more on the complicated side. So wooden engine, because this is going to require some wood gears. It's not that terrible. So let me create some sticks. There we go. Oops. Woo! Achievement! What was that? A bit rough around the edges? Alright. So now, looks like glass and a piston. So the recipe for a piston has changed. Now it uses a lever instead of a redstone, which is good because we do not have redstone yet. It's going to take a little bit before we can get redstone. There we go. And, oops, grab some glass. And wood on the top gives us a wooden engine. Nice. The start of something big. Cool. All right, so now we need to do crafting task. And I just need to basically combine one of each of these pipes with the water sealant. And I do not have the inventory space to do this. And this will create a waterproof pipe, which is very, very cool. And that should complete that. Nice. So we get extra pipe sealant. It's not a big deal. It's really hard to get that. It's just grabbing the cactus over there and converting it into the sealant, but it's okay. So what I'm going to do, just to use this, see, it already has about two buckets in here. I am going to automate this just a little bit. So let me drill down. Put this right there. Ah, this is filling the wrong way. I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's going the wrong way. So the next thing that I need to do is probably create a wrench. So let me go ahead and look at what it would take to create a wrench. So this is going to require a stone gear and three ingots. So I should have everything that I need for that, except for a crafting table. There we go. So how many gears? Just the one. So you basically create a wood gear, surround it with cobblestone, and that gives you a stone gear. There's a lot of achievements in Buildcraft. All right, hard as a rock. All right, so the next is iron ingots, and there we go. Yes, achievement, just hit it. Plenty of achievements. There is not gonna be any lack of achievements here. All right, so let me come up here and see how it is kind of blocked on this side. That means that the direction is going up. So I want to reverse that and do it like this. So now all of the water that's in this tank should drain down into this tank. And I do not know if this is going to be able to keep up. I might have to do a third. Oops, that is not what I wanted. Yeah, this does not seem to be keeping up very well. Why not? Let's do a third because of the fact that we have all of this limestone here. Might as well use it. So now let me create some barriers. Just do as I did before. So let me go ahead and create that. I don't want to bore you with all of the tedium of it. One thing that I will do while I still have you, I am going to look at carpenters. And I want to create a carpenter's ladder. And I want more than one ladder. Sorry about that. Cool. There we go. Distribute that. Still not enough, but that's fine. 8. Is that going to be enough? Maybe. Maybe not. I am not sure. So essentially, what I want to do is probably put a ladder inside of this area. And I'll probably do it like right here. And so I can climb up all the way up to the top of the silo. And if I need to do any kind of work in here, I'll have some sort of maintenance shaft that I can get to. And this will basically support any kind of block, just as any carpenter's block. And you can see that I can make it kind of silvery by using cobblestone, and that could work. So nice. So what I'm going to do, probably move this water, go ahead and finish building up a third level to this this water block or water tank, and I'll build up the sides to the water tower as well, and I'll be right back. All right, I am back, and I was able to build this up. It looks pretty good. I don't know how high I'm going to need it, but the problem... These water tanks are rather frustrating because it doesn't seem to be working. All of them are empty. They are barely able to keep up with the demand. You can see a tiny bit of stream of water going into this bottom one, but it's barely able to keep any fluid in it. I go down to the bottom and it's hovering around 3,000, so maybe... Since it's not going up or down, I'm assuming that it's just keeping up, just barely. So, might have to figure out something else to do with that. But for now, let's go ahead and continue on with the main building. And I played around with a couple of designs. This is a very short version of what I wanted. And over here, I am going with a fuller scale. And you can see that I am going for... somewhat of a industrial building, basically an old abandoned industrial building that you would see on the edge of a river. And I think that would look pretty good in this world. So let me come up here and let's go ahead and add a few things while I'm here. And I'm going to have to go into... the caves and stuff to see if I can find more limestone. The mariculture limestone is actually easy to find around the oceans. So if you're looking for it, that is probably the best place to go. So what I'm going to do here is make more scaffolding up. There we go. And up here, I am probably going to... bring this up a little bit more. There we go. And probably follow the same line that I have there. So this one has three in the middle. And that will work here. And I am needing to go a little bit higher. I have a plan. I have a plan. I haven't exactly pictured it all in my head, but I do have a plan. So here I can probably do the stairs again. I might end up having to change the other blocks here and there because right now I'm basically just reusing the same block, and that's probably going to get very boring pretty fast. I'm just... I should probably wait till I have flight to do some of these builds. But I like doing builds like this. Alright, so what I'm going to do is come back down to the surface. And let's take a look at what we have. I'm not done yet. But at least I'll be able to get a better sense of what I have. Oh yeah, that is looking good. And imagine this pattern. Basically, this one is three in between, and I have five in between, three, another five, and that's the center. So I'm going to make it parallel, symmetrical, on the other side. And what I want now is probably some carpenter slopes. So let's see if we can create some of those real quick. There we go. And... probably half a stack. Cool. Oop. I keep forgetting the other pattern for this. Ah, there it is. Need more sticks. There we go. Cool. And for the other top, I am going to have somewhat of a roof shape. might not go exactly how I have it planned, because I don't think these carpenter's wedges go in the angle that I would hope. And here, I'll probably do it like this. Oh, well, that's interesting. How have I not known this? Whenever you hold shift and use your mouse, it'll actually change into a different form of it. I have never known that. That is awesome. All right. Let's see. That may be tall enough. So let me grab these blocks and probably extend this out, since this is going to be extended anyways. Oh, scary up here. And these are going to go across the front. See if I can do this without dying. That was dangerous. That could have pushed me off the edge. I don't know if I'm placing these stairs correctly, but we'll see here in a little bit. There we go. And for you, I am wanting to basically follow the same path and have an archway like that. Might actually change the material for sure on this one. Maybe something like this. Now I'm gonna have to pick it all back up since I don't have a hammer. I guess I could create one now that I have iron. That was the only reason I didn't create it before, is because the hammer requires iron. Here we go. Let's see, can I put the wedges in here? Looks like I can. Tight fit. Oh, come on. Get in there. Is there any easy way to do this? Come on. Ah, there we go. Nice. All right. So let's see if I can put the rest of these here. And the backdrop is probably going to be these blocks. And yes, I know it's nighttime. I just do not want to die. Wonder if I can make it to the water. Jump! Oh, I'm not going to make it. I died. I was one block away. All right. Well, there's death number two. That is fine. I was hoping to be able to make it. All right, so once I sleep, let me check to see what this looks like. I'm gonna have to go get my stuff. That's a little bit too steep of an angle. Not exactly what I was hoping for on that. I might end up having to do something else. So let me go ahead and ignore that creeper. Let me play around with the other roof a little bit, and I'll probably go ahead and go into the mines, grab some more limestone, distribute this across a little bit further, so that way I can get a better sense of what I'm seeing here, and I will be back. Alright, I am back, and you can see that I have done quite a bit of work over here. Wasn't able to get as much as I wanted done because I kept running out of limestone. Getting this with the flint pickaxe is really not that fun. It takes a very long time just to collect a small amount. So this on the inside is going to be fairly flat because if you remember, I'm going to use like these oak planks here to kind of simulate boarded up windows. I might have the windows up there with the glass. Might be broken glass, could be stained glass. Haven't really decided on that, but at least the bottom floor is going to be boarded up because we are going for the abandoned building look because there was an apocalypse and I survived somehow and I found this building and decided to set up my camp in there. So that is essentially the story that I'm going with here. And I changed some of the blocks around, and I think those look pretty good. I went ahead and went with the slopes that I had. I think that'll go ahead and work. I made it a little bit taller than before, so that it'll actually stick up. And does the right side look taller? Maybe because I'm missing blocks down there. It kind of looks taller for some reason. So I do want to make this a little bit more safe. I am actually probably going to make a little building here, rather than just having it door right in the front. I am probably going to have some kind of foyer here. I'll need to move my tree farm, obviously. But I don't really have enough blocks to do all of this. But I'm going to try to repeat the pattern just like that. And I'll probably have this tall enough so that it'll arch over. But until I have a little bit more protection, I should probably sleep through the night. Otherwise, the mobs and stuff will come out and kill me. And nobody wants that because I already have too many deaths under my belt. So I could continue this line. This is probably big enough for my entryway. So one thing that I do want to do, I'm not going to be able to put it up here, but I should be able to at least put it on my doors down there. I want to look at Carpenter's garage door. And this is pretty simple. It's basically creating a chest with these carpenter's blocks. And it doesn't look like I have any on me. So let's go ahead and create a few carpenter's blocks. This does use a lot of wood. So that is something that you have to keep an eye on. There we go. And that creates 8 garage doors. And the nice thing about these garage doors is that they extend all the way down to the floor. So you only need 3 for right here. And you can see that it'll actually extend all the way down. And now it's just a matter of right clicking on it and it goes up. But unfortunately I can't reach it. So it probably makes sense to get a pressure plate as well. And those are pretty simple. It's just like the normal pressure plates that you would do any other mod, even vanilla. I can only create 2 right now, but I can do that and that. And now whenever I walk in and out, I can actually get it to open and close automatically. And this is going to be pretty important. Do I have any iron? Got this, a little bit of iron. Do I have any in the furnace cooking? Ah, nice. All right, so the other thing that I would really want to have is a carpenter's hammer, because without it, it's really difficult to do certain things. So I think it's about time that I create the carpenter's hammer. And that is pretty simple. My cell phone is on again, so let me turn that off. So let me create just 1. I only need the 1. And with a carpenter's hammer, it does take durability, but you should be able to at least change certain aspects. So here you can see shift right clicking on the pressure plate. I can have it set only active for monsters, animal, all entities, and only for players. And that one is exactly what I want, because if a mob is out here, I don't want him to trigger my pressure plate and open the door. Right now, I don't really have anything texture-wise that I would want to put on this. Maybe that. Yeah, it's kind of ugly. I'll need to get a grass block once I have silk touch. The other nice thing about a carpenter's hammer is that I can right-click without shift, and it'll change the appearance of this. It's really hard to tell. So let me go ahead and create some limestone blocks here. And I don't know what kind I'm going to want. And because these are, because it's a carpenter's block, you can basically put any block in that space, and that will be able to take on the texture, which is very, very cool. I kind of like that one. Yeah, might have a little bit up there so that the garage door is not going all the way up. But I think this will work out pretty well. Ooh, it looks like iron on this side. That's kind of funny. I wonder if that's intended. And I need to create on this side too, because there have been times that mobs have come down and killed me. Or not killed me, but shot at me from this direction. Here we go. And I'll probably want the same pattern as I have over there. And I don't have any pressure plates right now, so we'll have to just open this manually. But that is going to be nice. I am going to use the garage doors quite a bit, actually. Seems to make the most sense. Thinking industrial, big, giant garage doors that cover the buildings. So I am going to work on that in between episodes. I do need to go down into my mines again and see if I can fetch some more limestone. So by the next episode, I plan to have at least the front side complete. The sides and the back essentially going to look identical. Really no difference there, except for the fact that these are all three apart. Whereas I am doing 3-5-3-5-3-5-3 on this side, just to give it a little bit extra dimension. So I really hope that you enjoyed this episode. I still have quite a bit of work. I should have probably waited until I had flight, because I did die an extra time with fall damage whenever I was building way up there. But again, I hope that you enjoyed it. If you could rate and comment down below, it would be greatly appreciated. And also, if you like the series, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But for now, this is goodbye.